In this lesson, we're going to learn how to apply our two-point tracking data. Okay, so we've already gone ahead and gotten our track one and two finished. I challenged you in the last lesson to try to get your second track done on your own. If you didn't though, you can just open up 06 underscore begin in your project files, and I've gone ahead and finished this one up between lessons. So if you just select your track two here and we scrub backwards, you can see that that sticks pretty well onto that R on the tattoo pretty much throughout the track. We get a little bit of rotation, a little bit of position move, but this is going to give us the data we need to get this tattoo covered up. So what's next? I'm going to go ahead and clear the properties bin. And what we want to do next is to make sure that our project size is the 1280 by 720 that we're working with here. Now, this is something you probably should do at the beginning every time you read something in. But just in case you didn't, you don't have to do it before the tracker. But before we start adding some of these other nodes, it's very important that our composition is the same size as the read node we've dropped in. So just move over here to your properties panel, hit the S key, and right where you see full size format, just drop that down. And we're going to choose the 1280 by 720. That's what our read node was at. So that's great. You can go ahead and clear that properties bin again. And now we're ready to get started. So what I want to do is kind of come back over here to the first frame, which is going to be frame zero. And I want to draw a rotoscope around the tattoo. So this rotoscope is going to kind of outline the area, and it's going to give me a spot that I can just eventually make that rotoscope move along with my tracking data so that we can use the rotoscope to kind of isolate this area and affect it to cover up the tattoo. So come over here and hover over your draw node, click, and we'll grab that roto there. And you don't even have to plug this roto into anything. In fact, I would recommend just kind of leaving it off there and just making sure your viewer is plugged into your tracker. The roto doesn't have to be plugged in to anything yet because it'll end up being plugged in with an expression to the tracker later on. So let's go ahead and we'll just grab the Bezier from our roto node. And you might need to zoom out just a bit. I'm just middle clicking and dragging to move this around. And let's go ahead and we'll just click kind of here on the edges of those words. And just right about there. That looks pretty good. Okay. All right, so for the most part, I mean, that isn't obviously a perfect rotoscope, but it's going to get the job done for what we need. And you can adjust it a little bit if you need to, but you really only need these 4 points. So the next thing I want to do is just blur the area inside of the rotoscope. Now, if you had a person that had a lot of freckles, a lot of really obvious detail, you might not be able to get away with just a blur like what we're going to do. But she has pretty even skin, so I think this is going to work nicely. So let's just come over here to our filter button here. Just click, and we're going to grab the blur node. And I'm just middle clicking and dragging to pull this around. I'm going to drop the blur node between my tracker and my viewer. So my blur is affecting my read node upstream. And then let's go ahead and we'll pull up that size of the blur. So just until you're happy with that tattoo being blurred out, we're really just looking at the area inside of the rotoscope we created. And now I want to use this rotoscope to make everything outside of the roto clear because I really only want that tattoo to be blurred. So all we have to do is grab the mask port of our blur node and drop it onto the roto node. So now if I clear my properties bin so there's no line, you can kind of see what this looks like. And we can even refine this a little bit further if we want to. We can give it a little bit more blur, kind of feather the edges, and really make that look nice. But for now, it looks pretty good just as a still frame. If you never knew she had a tattoo, you probably wouldn't even notice this darker area. And we definitely can make this look even a little bit better. But let's just go ahead and play and see what's happening now. So we've got the blur in place and the rotoscope is doing its job as far as not having the whole image blurred, but I want the rotoscope to move along with the tattoo. So that gives us a good indication of where we need to place the node that's going to get that tracker data applied to it. And that's going to be a transform node. So simply select that roto node and then it's going to place a transform node downstream of the roto node just on this mask pipe, which is perfect. That's exactly where we want it. So just come over here to your transform button, choose the transform node, and you can see that now basically what's happening with this node tree is we have a rotoscope that feeds into a transform node. Once we hook the transform node up to the tracker, it's going to move that rotoscope around and therefore move the area that is visible with the blur. So let's come back over here to frame zero and start hooking up our data. So to hook this together, instead of using the link to, which is a little bit newer feature, I'm going to use the old tried and true method of just control clicking and dragging data from one box to another. So go ahead and double click your tracker to open that up, and you want to go to the transform tab of the tracker. And now you've got a translation, a rotation, and a scale. And that translation has basically been averaged between the two translations that we got from our two tracks. So that's going to give us a really good position data for that. And then we also have this center that has been tracked as well, which is very important for adding in here. So let's go ahead and link all four of these pieces of data, the translation, the rotation, the scale, and the center to our transform node. So all I'm going to do is bring my mouse over here and hover over the animation menu for my first property, the translate property, and I'm going to hold down the control button and then click that animation menu and just drag down and then hover over the property I want to link to, which is the translate of my transform node. And then I'll just release my mouse and that's going to link those pieces together. And you can see a couple things happen. So now the numbers here match exactly what we have in the translation for tracker one. And now we also have this little green line, which is basically showing that there's an expression linking the tracker to the transform node. And that's not really a pipe that you can change. So when those are diagonal, you just kind of have to deal with it. You try to get straight pipes everywhere else though. Okay, so now let's go ahead and link up these other three properties. I'm just going to hold the control button and then click the rotation property. Pull that onto the rotation property for the transform node. The same for the scale, hold control, click the scale animation menu, and drop that down onto the scale animation menu for transform. And then let's kind of scroll down here a little bit so we can see the center of our transform node. You can see those two values are different. Let's go ahead, control, and click and drag to the animation menu of the center on our transform. Okay, so now let's just clear that properties bin and go ahead and watch this animate through. So I'm just hitting the play button. And that stays with her pretty well. I mean, it's moving around really nicely. We've got some rotation. It's being covered up really well. But I think we could do a little bit better just to kind of tweak what the mask and or what the rotoscope and the blur look like. So let's go ahead and open back up both of those properties over here in our bin and just kind of right down here where we really get the tattoo looking pretty dark. I want to go ahead and maybe feather out my rotoscope a little bit. So just come over here to the roto and let's pull open that feather property. Now you see that if I do it too much, it's going to go all the way outside of her arm and start to blur this area here and here. So we don't want it feathered that much. I'm just going to do it just right in, right about there. So it's going to be just kind of to the edges of her arm. And then let's go ahead and maybe bump the blur up a little bit higher too. So now the blur is going to look just better on the inside. It's not going to be so dark. Let's kind of drag this back a little bit and see what it looks like at the beginning. I think that that looks pretty good, but it looks like the feather is too much here at the beginning. So let's go ahead and pull that feather back even further. And if you want to, you know, we can't feather it too much more on this side because it gets so close to her wrist on the edge, but we can feather more on this side over here. So if you just click one of those anchor points a couple times, you're going to get this little line that pops out, and you can just pull this, and that's going to feather just this one side. So I'll do this at the bottom as well. Just click and pull that out, and it's going to feather that just one side of the rotoscope. So we'll clear that properties bin, and that looks much better. Now, again, if you want the rotoscope to be more feathered, you're just going to have to be careful about where this anchor point here is landing. So obviously you want it outside of the tattoo, but to feather this very much at all is going to give you a little bit of spill over onto her shirt, which is not very desirable. So you just gotta balance that. And I think this looks pretty good here. If we look up here, we can choose the zoom level that we want. And if we just put that either at times one or divide by one, it's gonna be the same. This is what it's gonna look like at full size. And honestly, I think that looks pretty good still. So if I just kinda do a middle click here to resize that, we can watch that play through. And the data has been applied really nicely. I think the blur looks great. And it really moves very, very nicely with her arm. So great job on that. Hopefully you were able to get your tracking data between lessons. Again, if not, you could just follow along with what we already had here and just be able to apply the data in this lesson. So that's kind of just everything we went over here. And then you also learned how to cover up a tattoo using a rotoscope. So that was just kind of a bonus on learning how to apply that two-point tracking data. Now in our next lesson, I want to show you another way to use two-point tracking data, which is for image stabilization. So sometimes your subject might be moving, but you also have a shaky camera. So this shot was shot with a tripod, but sometimes you're going to shoot with a handheld. So whenever you do that, you're also going to be using a two-point track to stabilize the image. Now, not every time. Sometimes you can use a one-point, but most of the time, you probably want a two-point track just because handheld is going to have rotation in it. So that just kind of makes sense. So we're going to learn how to do that in our next lesson. And that's going to be pretty similar to this one, but there's just a slightly different workflow. So if you want to know how to do that image stabilization, stick around for our next lesson.